This is KLBK's The Blitz, Friday night high school football.
Welcome back to the second half of the Blitz. We pick up with two-way action, starting with the New Deal Lions hosting the Smyre Bobcats. Lions up 7-0 on the first, and Larrick Eaton, he is all over preseason watch list. He gets the sweep, 29 yards. He gets all the way down to the one. He's a monster in this game. He would score on the very next play to make it 13-0 for New Deal. Still in the first, Ethan Ramirez's pass picked off by Kendrick Nelson, and he's headed the other way. Offense and defense, New Deal feeling it everything in this one. Very next play, Harley Patterson. It's a play-action pass going wide open down the field to Kyler Reed. New Deal feeling it. They are back this season. New Deal wins this one 55-8. Got the season started off right. The Ropes Eagles in their first game moving from six-man to 11-man football, traveling to the Lochney Longhorns early in this one. Ropes dropping back. They're looking for the big play, but Lochney's Josh Cienfuegos with the pick. And then still in the first, Lochney's Nathan Ciencernos. He gets the handoff. They're doing offense and defense just like New Deal here. He breaks the tackles. He scores. Then Ropes the other way. They have a third down. RJ Medrano, he's scrambling. They're trying to get something going. Their first game here in 11-man. He gets stopped. The Lochney defense stepping up once again. Lochney wins this one 39-14. Ropes at home next week, still trying to get that first win. Now we'll look at a few more scores here. Tulia beating Floydada 28-26, while Hale Center getting a big win over Seagraves there, pretty convincing, 32-14. Post, the defending state runner-ups, they get a huge win there. Go back, New Home getting the win over Odessa, 51-0. And Sudan beating Olden, a back-and-forth game in that one. That one finishes 37-27. Also in this one, Crosbyton losing to Shamrock. That's 28-14. Tough one for Crosbyton. A low-scoring game. Rawls, one of the better teams in the area on 2A, though, losing 7-0 to Farwell. Six-man action now as Spring Lake Earth is making their six-man debut against Whit Harrell. They get on the board first. Braxton Etheridge finds Coolier Crumb for the first six-man TD in school history. But Whit Harrell strikes right back. They're now down 8-6 after they score. And David Ramirez, some nifty moves. He's going to get in as well. Panthers miss the kick. The lead now 12-8. Check out this touchdown from Spring Lake Earth on the very next possession. Evan DeLeon jukes the defender, throws back across the field. This time it's Etheridge on the receiving end. He scores, makes it 16-2 Wolverines. They would the lead at last check. Spring Lake Earth 46, Whit Harrell 24. Really showing out early on in six-man action there. Actually, our first game of the season was also a six-man game. Last night, Cotton Center hosting Southland. Early in this one, the scoring gets going. A kickoff return by Ray Flores for the touchdown. That makes it 6-0 Eagles very early on in the season. And then still in the first, Southland with the ball again. Cordell Benham punches it in from a few yards out. Eagles up 12-0. They're rolling. But Cotton Center would respond. Quarterback Sterling Berry, he gets away from the Eagles. Down the sideline he goes, finds pay dirt. That cuts the lead in half, 12-6. Later in the game, Cotton Center, they tie it up with Berry's pass to Bronson Alvarado. Back and forth all game, but Cotton Center actually comes back to win this one 49-44. That snaps a 29-game losing streak for the Elks, so congratulations to Cotton Center. Now looking at a few six-man scores. Borden County once again dominating 62-42 right there. O'Donnell, big win over Gordon there, 60-36. Continue to move on. Hermley gained a big win over Wellman Union, actually. That's a good start for Hermley, 52-8. Silverton not being able to get it, but Anton, one of our local teams here, gets that 50-38 win. Good start to the season for them as well. Rule barely edging out Wilson, 42-41. Another game that was back and forth all game long. Next, Jayton, one of our best teams, beating Ira, another really good, talented team, 50-28. Motley County was in the state championship last year, but lose their very first game this season, 58-36, trying to do what they did last year, but they struggled early, come back and win, and at least get to a state championship. Make sure you don't go anywhere. We'll be right back with more of the Blitz.